You all would have been, you know, showing a smiling face because you have been saved from CET, right? So finally, you all are officially into 11th standard. Good, my dears. So, well, that's fine. That's really good. So, well, but we had begun with the 12th standard chapter, that was human reproduction. And we had already seen in our earlier lectures about something called as the male reproductive structure and how the gametogenesis, that is the spermatogenesis, takes place. And we have also seen about the oogenesis, that is how the secondary oocyte is going to be taking place, right? How it is going to be formed, along with all the accessory structures and everything we have done in detail. And today we have to go ahead with the next part, that's going to be, as I told you, that I had divided this chapter into three parts. So this is the third part, which is going to be including, I know, I don't know why they are coming as blank. Now, I really don't know. I seriously, I'm not sure, like, why it is not, you know, being, is it blank slides for all of you all or only few of you all? All of you all are having a doubt with, I mean, a blank slide in your this. Oh, okay. Let's see what can be done. So I told you, in fact, I was trying to figure it out, you know, that what was going wrong. But let's see. They are going to be the ones, beta. Those are going to help in the storage of the milk. Okay, those follicles are going to be helping in the storage of the milk, which will ultimately form the tubules of the lobules. Okay, yeah, before I move ahead with the third part, any difficulty with the earlier two? So anyone has got any problems with the spermatogenesis, oogenesis, or in general, any structures associated with the male and female reproductive structures? Huh. What is the function of corona radiata? It's going to be giving an additional what we say, protection and support. Okay, so it's a protection and support of corona radiata, which will help the mitosis, which are going to be, you know, going on, which would eventually get arrested at metaphase two, right? So for that, they require a protective layer over it. So corona radiata basically is more of a protective layer over it. Okay, yeah. Anything else, my dears? Anything else regarding the earlier part? Or shall I move ahead with the third part and the concluding part of this chapter? Shall I go ahead? So, let's talk about something which is... Discussion of the papers, yeah, we'll go ahead with it eventually. I'll just get the, I mean, because my backlog lectures are over now. So the students who had joined late, and I had promised them that I'll be taking their backlog lectures of the chapters that were pending. So I've completed with all the backlog lectures. I've completed with Living World chapter. I've completed with Cell Unit of Life chapter. And I've also completed with Biological Classification chapter. And you all had joined when we were supposed to start cell cycle, cell division chapter. So from there onwards, you all are with me. So till now, for all the students, I guess, this goes for all the students. Living World is completed. Biological classification is completed. Cell unit of life is completed. Cell cycle, cell division is completed. And this is the fifth chapter that is ongoing, right? So almost we have completed five chapters for this entire batch, I can say. Yeah, this is the fifth chapter, the concluding part that we are going ahead with, na? Good. So, you should study from NCERT. 100 times I've repeated this. That study exclusively from NCERT, beta. Make your NCERT language your friend. The PPTs or the modules are going to be, you know, like rather, in fact, the PPTs are going to be something which will make the concept very clear. Because NCERT has got a content which is to the point content. And many a times, why this is happening, how this is happening, are the question marks that remain in our mind. So in that case, you know, your PPTs will help you to understand the concepts perfectly. So it's an additional support, but the language should be purely NCERT language. I'm again and again repeating that maximum of the questions are going to be set for your examination from line to line, word to word NCERT. So please, my dears, please study NCERT. Additionally, you can use PPTs for the conceptual clearance and modules for some extra points. That's your choice. But NCERT thoroughly karna hai bas. Okay. So right now also, you know, like my current batch students, you won't believe this, but my current batch students na, unko maine ek assignment diye hue hai jo aapko bhi de dungi main, which is, you know, fill in the blanks assignment. So your entire NCERT I have made into fill in the blanks, and you should be fit that with every blank. Every blank should be known to you all. Okay? No, not necessary. Not necessary. Then what is the use? There should be something which has to be unique and special, huh? Correct? Yes. Yeah. I'm going to give all these. I'm going to give you all these for practice. Don't worry. This is for sure. So you don't have to worry about it. But it's not going to be now. It's going to be a bit later once we start with the revision lectures. So definitely I'll help. I'm going to be here with you all for the next 2 years. Yeah. I'm not going to run away anywhere. No, you have to study for NCERT only. Others are supports. Again, I'm telling you, others are supports. You are not going to study that. You're going to only read that, try to understand the NCERT content using the support from these two systems. Okay? Study karna matlab padna, bar bar padna, revise karna, uske jo important points hai, unko bar bar memorize karte rehna, usko hum study kehte hai. Ek bar read karenge to usko study nahi kaha jata hai, beta. Reading once is not a study. Reading once is just to complete something. Yaar, kuch to test ek bar read karke dekhta hun. That is called as, ek bar dekhna. Study ka matlab hota hai, bar bar wahi cheez, bar bar wahi cheez, bar bar wahi cheez karte rehna. So I am not telling you to study the modules bar bar padhte raho, nahi bol rahi hu main. Wo read karne ki cheez hai. जो बार बार पढ़ने की चीज है, पढ़ना एंड रीड करना में जमीन आसमान का फर्क है. फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट पर्टिकुलर डिफरेंस. व्हेन आई से यू हैव टू स्टडी फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी, दैट मींस यू हैव टू रीड दैट चैप्टर 200 टाइम्स इन द कमिंग 2 इयर्स. उसको कहते हैं स्टडी. और एक बार पढ़ के कंसेप्चुअल समझ लेना इज रीडिंग पार्ट. Is associated part. It is not a study part. I will never tell anyone to study from module. Did you get me? It's totally different. Study has to be purely NCERT. Okay. And why we have to study from three things? I have never told you to study from three things. I am only telling you to study from NCERT purely. For support, you have got 1,000 books. Are you going to refer 1,000 books? In the market, if you go, you will get confused looking at the names of the 1,000 books. Kaunsa refer karu? I will never say study the reference books. I will never say go and get 10 books and start studying from there. I know it's hopeless. It's useless. But for support, you require something. Na? To understand a particular concept, you require something. Because NCERT is very to the point. Detailing that why this is happening and how this is happening is not given. So to understand that, to make your, you know, understand a complete concept, you have to read the other contents, not study the other contents. Am I making this very clear to you, Krishna? Is this very clear? That you don't have to study from three different things, please. But you have to study from NCERT for sure. This goes to all of you all. And as far as your 12th standard syllabus is concerned, you have to study from government textbook because the language of government textbook is quite different from NCERT textbooks. And if you write NCERT textbook language in your board examinations, aapko bade bade zeros milenge. So uske liye aapko 12th standard ka government textbook by default padna padega. स्टडी करना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो प्लीज बी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट फ्रॉम वेयर टू स्टडी. आई होप ऑल द एंटायर बैच हैज मेड दिस वेरी क्लियरली फ्रॉम वेयर टू स्टडी. ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल विल बी स्टडिंग फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी टेक्सटबुक ऑफ 11th एंड 12th स्टैंडर्ड एंड ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल विल बी स्टडिंग द 12th स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड टेक्सटबुक फॉर योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. Content is the same, language is different. When I say that during spermatogenesis, the germinal epithelium of the testes are going to be giving rise to spermatogonia, let it be any textbook in this world, the fact is not going to change, beta. Fact remains the same, but the language is going to change. So please follow the language of your board textbooks when you write for board examinations. And for your competitive examinations, let it be your KBPY, let it be your CET, let it be your this PMTs, matlab apna NEET, koi bhi ho, uske liye aapko NCERT se padhna hai. Huh? Got it, my dears? Yeah. So this is the third part of the human reproduction and reproductive health chapter, basically. So we come ahead with something called as fertilization. Fertilization is the union of two opposite types of gametes, that's spermatozoa and ova. The semen is a mixture of spermatozoa and accessory fluids. Come on, I want you all to tell me the names of the three glands which are helping in generating this accessory fluids. Tell me the three names of the glands which are, please. Hey, it's not sebaceous. Ah, very good. Who is this? Yes, very nice, Zui. Yes, very good. Teen saath mein type karke de do. Ek ek karke nahi dena. Ek hi line mein teen type karke de dena, jaise Zui ne mujhe diya hai. She has given all the three names. Excellent. Dia Patel, perfect, my dear. Very good, my dear. Perfect. Come on, others. Very good, Vaishnavi. Excellent. Others. Start typing your answers. Risha, very nice. Perfect answer. Perfect answer, bacha. Very good. The question is, tell me the names of the three accessory glands of the male reproductive system. Because here they are saying that the semen is going to be a mixture of spermatozoa and accessory fluids. So the three glands which make up this accessory fluids. Excellent. Very, very right. Very right, Siddhika. Perfect answer, my dear. Very nice. Others. Good morning. Very good, Bhumi. Yes. Yes, Palak. Very nice. Yes. Yes, Akanksha. One is remaining. You have given two, which are correct. Huh? Dono answers sahi hai. Very good, Darshanita. Perfect. Yes, Akanksha. You have given the third answer correctly, my dear. Very good, Shachi. Very good, Niharika. Yes, Divya. Very good, Bita. Yes, Valentina. Right answer. Perfect answer. Perfect answer. Very good. So I'm very happy, you know, when I see these answers, na, that boosts my energy to, you know, teach you all in a very enthu mood. Nahi to kuch answer nahi doge na, to aise ho jata hai, yaar, kuch to bolo na, please. Yes, Krishna, you are right, my dear. Correct, you are right. Yes, perfect. Okay, so you know the names. Of course, it's the seminal vesicle, prostate gland, and Cowper's gland. Some of you all have given as bulbourethral, that's fine. It's one and the same. Perfect. Very nice. Yes, Vidhi. Yes, Vidhi. Right, Bacha. So these three glands, the secretions hai, along with the spermatozoa, that will altogether comprise of the semen. Now, I'm sure you remember the percentages also. Almost 60% is going to be the seminal fluid. Around 30% is going to be the prostate gland fluid. You remember all these? Right? Okay. So you know the percentages approximately also. Anyway, now what happens? Once the semen is deposited within the vagina, the spermatozoa proceed on their journey into the uterus and through the uterus to reach onto the top of the oviducts, especially the ampullary region. You remember that I had told you that fertilization takes place in the ampulla of the fallopian tube. So now these spermatozoa have to reach through the uterus, across it, and reach the ampulla of the fallopian tubes. Correct? Although oviducts as we call them. Although spermatozoa can swim several millimeters each second, their trip through the uterus and to the oviduct requires an increase in their motility. So though they are already motile, okay, they can travel up to several millimeters per second. Okay, but still they need to boost up their speed. Okay, on the first hand, ejaculation of semen in the vagina triggers the motility of spermatozoa. So the first thing you know that is going to enhance the speed of the spermatozoa is the ejaculation inside the vaginal tract of the female. So they automatically, you know, get activated to move at a faster rate. This is aided further by muscular contraction of the walls of the uterus and the oviducts. We already know that the uterus is going to be having the myometrium, that is going to be the middle layer, which is made up of muscles. So as and when the spermatozoa are going to enter into the vagina of the female, her muscles will start contracting. And when the muscles will contract, it's automatically going to pull the spermatozoa towards the inner side. So a suction-like thing will be applied. So don't you think it will cause the movement to be more faster? Hai na? So first thing kya beta? First thing is, of course, that the ejaculation will trigger the motility of the spermatozoa. And second thing is the muscular layer of the vagina and the uterus basically will contract, helping in pulling them inwards. Two things. What is the third most important thing? See, movement of sperm towards the egg, what happens? It involves capacitation of sperms reaching the vagina. So what is capacitation? Let us see what is capacitation. Here, as many as 50% are demotilized, broken, and destroyed. So many of them, so almost 50% of them, they are degenerated, they are destroyed. Why? Why are they destroyed? Probably they couldn't, get acclimatized. That means they couldn't get used to the acidic pH of the vagina, or maybe the muscular action was so strong that they couldn't withstand it. I'll tell you what is capacitation. Yeah, the entire process is there for capacitation. Yeah? So because of that, now 50% have got destroyed. So whatever number are supposed to reach, usme se 50% to competition ke bahar chale gaye. 50% are out of the competition, right? Remaining sperms undergo capacitation. So the remaining 50% are the only ones which will undergo this capacitation process. This process requires 5 to 6 hours. So for this capacitation to take place, the 50% of the remaining spermatozoa will take almost 6 hours. But why do they take 6 hours? Itna kya ho raha hai? What exactly is capacitation? So see this graph. Acrosome membrane becomes thin. So this is the process of capacitation. See, what exactly is capacitation? So it begins with the acrosome membrane becoming thin. I hope you all remember what is acrosome. On the top of the, in the head region, there was Golgi bodies. Yes, helmet like thing. Yes, Golgi vesicles which had formed the acrosome. And I definitely remember telling you all that, remember that acrosome contains sperm lysine. Yes, of course. Profibrinolysines are also to help in liquefy. Correct, my dear. Perfect. So you remember that I had told you all that the acrosome contains spermalysines. And I told you that that particular word will be asked again when I'll be teaching you all the fertilization event, right? Yes. So what happens? This acrosome ka jo layer hai na, outer side, it becomes thin. Okay. Calcium ions enters the sperm and their tails begin to show rapid whiplash movements. You know what is whiplash? Whiplash is like, what do we say? You know, jab hum kisi ko it will further aid. Yeah. Prostaglandin ka contraction always there. That is the reason, na. So muscles contract hote and it's going to enter. Very correct. Yeah. So whiplashing means, you know, like just like for a horse, how we use a whiplash. Piche jaake aage. Piche jaake aage. Aise jo maarte hai na, piche se aage. That is called as, when we hit someone with a whip. Yeah. So how do we hit? We go backward and then we move forward. So this movement is called as whiplash. So the tails of these spermatozoa will start moving like this way in a full speed because of the entry of calcium. So thinning of the acrosome and entry of calcium ions is going to cause a whiplash movement into the tails of the spermatozoa. Okay. Now what happens here? This is called as capacitation. This process is called as capacitation. Only calcium ions are going to enter because that is going to be what? That is going to be the, you have heard about depolarization and polarization about the charges, negative, positive charge. So here there has to be a positive charge inserted into the spermatozoa head. So the maximum available ions in our, you know, system is going to be the calcium ions. And do you also recollect that somewhere calcium ions were being formed? Do you recollect? Wherever calcium ions being formed. Try to recollect calcium ions. Kiske secretions mein hote hai calcium ions? Exactly. Prostate gland secretion. Exactly. Very true. Very true. Okay. So see, so the acrosome membrane becomes thin. Calcium ion enters the sperm and their tails begin to show rapid whiplash movements. Theek hai? Understood. Now what happens? As a result of capacitation, sperm becomes extra active and begins to start moving upwards from the vagina into the uterus and then to the ovida. Okay? Ionic. Yeah. That was for ionic. Yes. Exactly. Depolarization, polarization due to Na plus and K plus in the nerves. Just like that. Okay? Exactly similar polarization, depolarization reaction is going to take place with you. Now what has happened? Yes, exactly. So now what has happened, beta? So now they are going to be at full speed. Who? Only those 50% who are surviving. There are only 50% who are surviving, right? 50% are out of race. So these 50% who are surviving will undergo capacitation, that is thinning of acrosome layer and entry of calcium ions, causing the spermatozoa to move at a full speed. This particular, event is called as capacitation. Understood what is capacitation? The other 50 have degenerated earlier only. As I said, it could be because of various reasons. Probably they were not able to withstand the acidity, or probably they were not able to withstand the muscle contractions or something like that. So in maximum, studies that have been carried out, 50% of these spermatozoa are out of the competition earlier only. And rest, which are 50 now, they need to be undergoing this capacitation reaction. Okay, now see what happens. Now here, someone was talking about prostaglandins, so here the word is coming. The prostaglandins activate the sperms further. The vestibular secretions of the female also enhances sperm's motility. So in total, the nature wants the spermatozoa to go and fertilize the egg. So it's going to help in all possible ways. Okay. So as just now I told someone that you have to study from NCERT, but you have to take the help of PPTs and modules and, the lectures. So it's something like that way. The final aim is what? What is my final aim? That you crack your NEET or you go into your research field or you go into your dream career, whatever you want to do. For that, you have to do one thing. So the sperms have to move on their own, but they'll be helped by n number of, factors that will upgrade their motility. Okay. Capacitation is the entry of Ca plus in the sperms, which result in rapid whiplash movement along with the thinning of the acrosome membrane. This is correct, but along with the thinning of the acrosome membrane. Okay, yes. Now see, the sperms swim at an average of 1.5 to 3 mm per minute. So in this way, their motility is going to be enhance. Sperms reach up to the ampulla as a result of their own swimming and partly by contraction of uterus, fallopian tubes stimulated by oxytocin of female. Okay, oxytocin, a very important hormone, especially synthesized in during the time of copulation. So the oxytocin will help in, further reaching to the right place of the spermatozoa near the ampullary region. Less speed, yeah, but for them still it's a very high speed. So when you, eventually, not today, but in the coming lecture, when I'll show you the, the actual reaching of the spermatozoa and making a pore inside the egg and all, now that time you will come to know that it's so fast, it appears to be so fast. Okay. So after capacitation, they reach the ampulla within 5 minutes. Within 5 minutes, though the speed is such slow. They can remain viable for 24 to 48 hours. Maximum, it's 72. But minimum 24 to 48 hours, they can be surviving. The ova for about 24 hours. And so look at the equation. 24 hours and 24 to 48 hours, or maybe, maximum 72 hours. So this entire event has to take place within the given stipulated time. Only then it's going to be successfully doing its job. Fine? Okay. Any difficulty on this slide, whatever has been put up? Is there any doubt? Is there any difficulty? Just check. Yeah, what do you mean by viable? Viable means capable of doing a work, capable of performing its function. That is called as viability. So it's not only surviving, but surviving and capable of performing work is called as viability. You missed it. It's simple. Acrosome membrane is going to become thin. Okay. And on thinning, what will happen? The calcium ions would enter inside the head and they will reach and they will cause the tails to, perform a whiplash movement. So just as we use a whip now, how do we use a whip? It goes back, it comes forward. It goes back, it comes forward. So like that way, they all will move together, like, going back and coming forward. A swift movement can be seen. Who releases oxytocin? Pituitary gland. Oxytocin is going to be released by pituitary gland. Okay? Yeah. So no confusion. Yahan tak samajh mein aa gayi baat? Good. Good, beta. Okay. Now what happens? Here you can see the... They are already being present in the prostate gland ka secretions na. So it's always going to be present all inside it, so more will be attracted to come inside. Okay, so only calcium ions. The prostate gland is not going to make any other, ionic form mein dusra koi nahi hai usme. Calcium ions hai, to wo aur zyada calcium ions ko andar lene ko help karta hai. Fine, great. Now see, out of 200 to 400 million sperms, only few hundred manage to reach the ampulla. So we have seen that so many were there and now few hundreds, 400 million. Imagine 400 million mein se sirf 100 are capable of reaching the ampulla. So you remember something called as survival of the fittest? Suna hai aapne? Natural selection and survival of the fittest is something which we have heard of. Yes, Darwin's theory. Very correct, Peter. So something like that. So there were 40,000, out of which only few hundreds are going to be selected to reach the ampulla. Though many sperms reach the ampulla, only a single sperm fertilizes the ovum. Now this is the beauty. Aise kaise possible hai? How is this possible? There are so many who are reaching, na? then how come only one is capable of entering? Baki ke kidhar chale gaye fir? Correct. That question will always be there in our mind. So see what happens. So that there is only monospermy and not polyspermy. Monospermy means only one sperm ka entry. Polyspermy means many sperms ka entry. So polyspermy will never happen. Only monospermy is going to be carried out. So how is that procedure going to be brought about? So see, a sperm after reaching the egg or the ovum comes to lie against it. Means they are going to lie side by side. Comes to lie against it ka matlab kya hai? Baju baju mein aa jaate hain. They lie side by side. Its acrosome releases the sperm lysine. So now you understood the acrosome and the egg are in contact with each other. So what will happen now? They will start releasing the sperm lysine. Okay. So what are the sperm lysine? Higher uridase enzyme, corona penetrating enzyme. These are all your sperm lysine. They separate and dissolve the cells of corona radiata. So the first thing to do is what? Corona radiata abhi bhi intact hai. So corona radiata ke cells ko baju mein hata kar unke beech mein se ye spermatozoa ko entry leni hai. So here you can see sperm nucleus containing the chromosome, acrosome containing the nucleus. Now here you can see perforations in the acrosomal wall. तो ये देखो ये एक्रोसोमल वॉल में परफोरेशंस हो गए हैं. परफोरेशंस मींस क्या? होल्स बन गए हैं. देन सी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. दिस इज द कोरोना रेडिएटा. यू कैन सी दिस ब्लू सेल्स आर कोरोना रेडिएटा. सो नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड बिकॉज ऑफ दी स्पर्म लाइजीन्स द कोरोना. ये रेड कलर के डॉट्स दिखाई दे रहे हैं आपको. कैन यू सी दैट रेड कलर के डॉटेड थिंग्स? दैट इज दे आर गिविंग आउट दे आर द स्पर्म लाइजीन्स आर बीइंग गिवन आउट फ्रॉम द हेड रीजन causing the corona radiata cells to dissolve. Okay, so these corona radiata cells needs to be dissolved. So jo bahar tha ab wo corona radiata ko stick ho chuka hai aur yahan par uske perforations ho chuke hain, so that the contents, that is the sperm lysines, can be squeezed out. And once the sperm lysines are squeezed out, see, it is getting entry via the corona radiata into this blue color ka structure. Can you see this blue color ka structure? Huh? So what is this blue color ka structure? You know, plasma membrane of the oocyte. But it has to even cross zona pellucida. You can see this is third number, that is zona pellucida. So it has to cross the zona pellucida also. Okay, so how do they do it in a very systematic way? Just see. So here, the sperm after reaching the egg, or the ovum, it comes to lie against it. Then they separate and dissolve the cells of corona radiata. So the sperm head passes through the zona pellucida of the egg. The zona pellucida has fertilizin receptor protein. It's called as ZP3, ZP2. ZP stands for zona pellucida. ठीक है. तो जोना पेलुसिडा 3, जोना पेलुसिडा 2, ये ऐसे उसके प्रोटीन रिसेप्टर्स के नाम है. तो ये जो रिसेप्टर्स है ना, दे आर मेड अप ऑफ प्रोटीन. किसके लिए है ये? दे आर द रिसेप्टर्स ऑफ व्हाट? दे आर द रिसेप्टर्स ऑफ फर्टिलाइजिंग एंजाइम. हु हैज गॉट द रिसेप्टर्स फॉर फर्टिलाइजिंग एंजाइम? जोना पेलुसिडा. सो दिस जोना पेलुसिडा हैज गॉट रिसेप्टर्स which are made up of proteins, and they will attract fertilizing enzyme. Did you all understand what is the meaning of this sentence very clearly? A very important sentence, my dears. If not understood, please ask me. I'll repeat one more time for all of you all. Corona penetrating enzymes. Yes, you're right. Yes, the ovum is secondary oocyte, perfectly right. When the sperm releases the lysine, the secondary oocyte turns into an egg. Yes, my dear. Bilkul correct answer. Bilkul correct. But see what is happening. See. So, again I'll tell you. Firstly, the spermalysines are going to be present in the acrosome of the sperm. Correct? Now, as and when the acrosome comes in contact with the corona radiata, the acrosome will start giving out these spermalizings via its acrosomal end via perforations. Okay. Now, these particular spermalizings will dissolve the corona radiata cells and allow the sperm head to come in contact with zona pellucida. Correct? Now, this zona pellucida has got receptor protein which will receive fertilizin. So, they are specifically the receptors of whom? Fertilizin. Yes, fertilizin exam is present in the acrosome. Correct. Okay, now see, huh? The fertilizin, the zona pellucida has fertilizin receptor protein ZP3, ZP2. The fertilizin binds to specific acid protein, anti-fertilizing of the sperm. Okay, so there is going to be what? Fertilizin, anti-fertilizing reaction. Okay, so see, the fertilizing, so zona pellucida has fertilizing receptor proteins. Okay, they will bind with whom? They will bind with the anti-fertilizing of the sperm. It brings about attraction of the sperms to the egg to enhance fertilization. You understood this? So what is happening? The zona pellucida is in fact causing the attraction of these, you know, spermatozoa to come towards it. Got it? Understood? So that, you know, the fertilization event does take place in a very systematic way. Okay? Fertilizing, anti-fertilizing interaction is species specific. Now, this is the most important sentence, species specific. That means no two different species can, two different species, can ever naturally, again, a very important word, naturally produce a hybrid. Okay? Two different species can never naturally make a hybrid because of this fertilizing, anti-fertilizing reactions. Okay? So it is going to be maintained by the species. No, it needs to attract because, it needs to attract because the one who is the most competent, the one who is the best suited will be the first one to reach that particular fertilizing receptor protein. So the one who is the fastest, strongest, and the best will automatically get selected from the rest. So zona pellucida kya karta hai? Jitne bhi spermatozoa aa rahe hai, unme se fastest, strongest, best jo hai, usko select kar leta hai. Okay, so see how the nature is selecting the things. 50% of the population ko pehle hi degenerate kar diya because probably they were not competent enough. Rest 50% ko capacitation karane diya, acrosome ka reaction karane diya, hai na? And then the zona pellucida is just checking out which one is the best. Got it? If tie between two? No, generally there is no tie because the first one, as and when the first one, even by a fraction of a second, touches those fertilizing receptors first, there's going to be a drastic change in zona pellucida. So what is that? That we'll see. Okay, yeah. So fertilizing, anti-fertilizing reaction is species specific. Okay, thus the fertilizing, anti-fertilization reaction is also called as compatibility reaction. Are the two gametes compatible with each other or not? Each spermatozoa has a unique DNA. Yes, beta. Because they are going to be what? They are a product of meiosis from the parent. Na? That uniqueness is always going to be there in each of the gametes. Correct, my dear. Bilkul correct. So, idhar tak ki kahani samjhi. Entry of spermatozoa into the egg, what all things are happening? Anti-fertilization. Anti-fertilizing, see, fertilizing is going to be present with the zona pellucida. Huh? It's like a lock. It's like a lock. Okay. And anti-fertilization is fertilizing is like a key. So the spermatozoa ka jo acrosome hai, usme ye chemical present hota hai, which is called as anti-fertilizing. Now the lock has to be opened by the key. So the fertilizing, anti-fertilizing will react and it will, you know, like allow this particular sperm to cross the zona pellucida. So if the zona pellucida needs to be crossed, the lock has to be opened, without which no entry. For this now, so the fertilizing receptor protein of the zona pellucida is like a lock. Anti-fertilizing is like a key. So with the key, the lock would be opened so that the nucleus of the sperm can enter inside the egg via the zona pellucida. Right now? Exactly. Yes, my dear. So now the things are very simple. How this mechanism ensures that only one sperm, that is yet to come, beta. That is yet to come. That how only one, that I'll tell you. That is yet to come. I'll explain that. That is on the next slide. But on this slide, any difficulties? Surely I'll explain that what exactly happens with the zona pellucida, that it won't allow anyone else to now enter inside. I tell you. Ye yahan tak samjha? Sure. Very good. Fine. So let's move ahead. Yeah. Now there is something called as acrosome reaction that is taking place. Let us see what is this. See, bolne ke liye na, it seems to be so simple. But प्रैक्टिकली जब हम इसको स्टडी करते हैं तो यू कम टू नो द ब्यूटी दैट हाउ दीज ऑल थिंग्स आर यू नो एक्चुअली गोइंग ऑन इन नेचर ना सो लुक एट इट एज द स्पर्म हेड टचेस द ज़ोना पेलुसिडा सो फर्स्ट इट हैड टच द कोरोना रेडिएटर राइट देन इट हैज टच द ज़ोना पेलुसिडा द लॉक इज ओपन नाउ सिंस द लॉक इज ओपन नाउ द स्पर्म हेड विल एक्चुअली टच द ज़ोना पेलुसिडा टू ओपन द लॉक इट हैड टच द रिसेप्टर्स Correct, na? Initially, to touch the zona pellucida, it couldn't directly touch the zona pellucida. It had to touch what? It had to touch the receptor, right? And when the receptor allowed that particular entry inside, now it has, now it has touched the actual membrane. Now it has touched the actual membrane. Now see where it is going to touch. So the sperm head touches the zona pellucida in the animal pole region. Animal pole region is somewhere where there is going to be the chromosomes of the egg. So the area where the chromosomes of the egg would be present would be called as the animal pole. Okay. Its acrosome covering ruptures to release the lytic enzymes acrosin or zona lysine. So see, there are so many lytic enzymes. Lytic means what, you know? The one which causes lysis. Lysis means breaking. Todne ka jo kaam karta hai. So what happens, see now, as the sperm head touches zona pellucida in the animal pole region, its acrosome covering ruptures. फट जाता है एंड फटने के बाद क्या रिलीज करता है द एंजाइम्स व्हिच विल कॉज ब्रेकिंग और डिसॉल्विंग ऑफ द ज़ोना पेलुसिडा नाउ ओके गॉट इट कॉल्ड एज एक्रोसिन और ज़ोना लाइसिन ठीक है तो अभी ज़ोना पेलुसिडा के अंदर एक्रोसिन जिसको ज़ोना लाइसिन भी कहते हैं जो जोना पेलुसिडा को लाइस करता है मतलब जोना पेलुसिडा में एक होल बनाता है जोना पेलुसिडा में एक पोर बनाता है वो पूरे जोना पेलुसिडा को डिस्ट्रॉय नहीं कर सकता इट कैन ओनली फॉर्म अ पोर इट कैन ओनली फॉर्म अ होल सो द वन हु इज केपेबल ऑफ बोरिंग अ होल इनसाइड द जोना पेलुसिडा वुड बी कॉल्ड अ जोना लाइसिन Or because it is being lysed from, it is dispersed from the acrosome. It is also called as acrosin. So, कोई भी word बराबर है. You can use the word acrosin also. You can use the word zonalizin also. Okay. So this zonalizin ने क्या किया? It has it has come in contact with a point in the zona pellucida. So see, they act on the zona pellucida at a point of contact. So entire zona pellucida mein kuch nahi hoga beta, jahan wo touch hua hai na head, bas usi point pe reaction hogi. So see, this causes egg reaction. अब इसको हम क्या कहते हैं, एग रिएक्शन. मतलब क्या होता है, देखो व्हाट इज एग रिएक्शन. अ स्मॉल फर्टिलाइजेशन कोन और कोन ऑफ रिसेप्शन इज फॉर्म ऑन द एग मेम्ब्रेन. अ कोन ऑफ रिसेप्शन मींस अ डिप्रेशन. तो ये ऐसा था जोना पेलुसिडा, ऐसा था तो ये कैसे हो गया बेटा, ऐसे हो गया. कैन यू सी माई फिंगर्स हाउ आई हैव डन. सो इनिशियली इट वॉज लाइक दिस वे. And now it is going to move a bit inward like this way to form a conical structure. So, ye conical structure bante hi what will happen? This is going to be the reception. Reception means the one who would be received inside this pocket. So, ek pocket ke jaisa na egg mein ban jata hai. Okay, egg ke membrane mein ban jata hai. The sperm head comes in contact with this cone. It results in the production of a weak wave of depolarization. Now the most important point is this, that once the head comes in contact with the egg membrane, because now it has already crossed the zona pellucida, right, and it is coming in contact with the egg membrane. So egg membrane kya ho gaya, egg membrane actually sharma jati hai bolte hai. तो वो एकदम से जो ऐसे मस्त गोल रहती है ना, वो एक डिप्रेशन ग्रुप बनाती है, कोन बनाती है. ओके, नाउ प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ बोथ सेल्स डिसॉल्व एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. सो एज एंड व्हेन देयर इज गोइंग टू बी अ वीक वेव ऑफ डीपोलराइजेशन. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डीपोलराइजेशन, डू यू नो? इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव चार्जेस. Just like Na plus K plus charges during the stimulus application, same type का ये depolarization होता है. मतलब क्या होगा, आगे समझेगा बेटा, आगे समझेगा. नहीं समझा है ना, टेंशन मत लो, यही साइड पे आगे समझेगा. ओके, प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द एग ऑल्सो एंड प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द स्पर्माटोजो ऑल्सो विल डिजोल्व एट दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. द स्पर्म न्यूक्लियस and the centrioles enter the egg. So who is going to enter the egg? The nucleus of the sperm and the centrioles would enter inside the egg, while the mitochondrial region, that is going to be called as the neck, along with the tail, everything will remain outside. It will remain in the zona pellucida region. It won't enter the egg. So egg ke andar kya jata hai? सिर्फ और सिर्फ न्यूक्लियस एंड सेंट्रियोल. सो डू यू रिमेम्बर प्रॉक्सिमल सेंट्रियोल नाम हमने किया था, प्रॉक्सिमल सेंट्रियोल एंड डिस्टल सेंट्रियोल. सो आई टोल्ड यू डिस्टल सेंट्रियोल फॉर्म्स द एन्युलस थ्रू विच द फाइन थ्रेड ऑफ द माइक्रोट्यूब्यूल्स विल रन टिल द एंड. एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट नियर द नेक रीजन, नियर द न्यूक्लियस, देयर इज गोइंग टू बी प्रॉक्सिमल सेंट्रियोल. हाँ, सो दिस प्रॉक्सिमल सेंट्रियोल एंड द न्यूक्लियस would enter inside the egg. Okay, got this? So one more time, I'll repeat till here. As the sperm touches the zona pellucida in the animal pole region, the acrosome ruptures. It releases the lytic enzymes called as acrosin, which will make a hole in zona pellucida. Okay, through this hole, the sperm will try to enter the egg membrane. But just because of this hole creation, there's going to be an egg reaction that will be initiated. Means what? Now the egg membrane knows that any time the spermatozoa will enter inside. ठीक है? So it is going to form a cone-like structure to receive the nucleus of the sperm. Okay? Now, as the sperm head comes in contact with this cone, it results in the production of a weak wave of depolarization, which causes the plasma membrane of both the cells, that is the egg cell ka plasma membrane as well as the sperm ka plasma membrane to get dissolved. Okay, so they will dissolve, and when it dissolves completely, now the sperm ka nucleus and the centriole will be received by the cone and accepted inside the egg. Okay, got this? Fine. So the sperm nucleus and the centriole enters the egg while other parts remain outside. Fine. Look at it. As soon as the sperm head touches the vitelline membrane. Now, where is the vitelline membrane? Now, here you can see this particular diagram. जो यहाँ पर बहुत easy बना देगा ये पूरी कहानी. तो ये देखो बेटा, ये zona pellucida है. यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हो यहाँ से spermatozoa ने entry ले ली है and it has created a pre-vitelline space. Okay, this is going to be a pre-vitelline space. Okay, and this is going to be the space which is created. और ये जो black वाला दिखाई दे रहा है आपको, ये ब्लैक लाइन जो है ना, इट इज द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन. सो एज सून एज द स्पर्म हेड टचेस द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन, अ कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन गेट्स एक्टिवेटेड चेंजिंग द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन इनटू अ फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन बाय डीएक्टिवेटिंग द स्पर्म रिसेप्टर्स ऑफ zona pellucida. ओके, नो, zona pellucida विल नॉट ब्रेक बेटा, बिकॉज इट इज ओनली दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट जहां वो चिपकेगा ना, सिर्फ उधर एक छोटा सा होल बनेगा, बाकी पूरा zona pellucida इंटैक्ट रहता है. zona pellucida को कोई हार्म नहीं कर सकता है. ठीक है, तो क्या हो गया देखो, कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन क्या हो गई देखो. नाउ यू कैन सी व्हाट इज द कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन. सी, एज सून एज द स्पर्म हेड टचेस द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन, अ कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन गेट्स एक्टिवेटेड चेंजिंग द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन इनटू अ फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन बाय डीएक्टिवेटिंग the sperm receptors of zona pellucida. So one, the first entry, जो पहला sperm है जिसने vitelline membrane को touch किया, zona pellucida के बाद आता है vitelline membrane. ये देखो, ये red color की membrane है, ये zona pellucida है, और ये जो black color की membrane है वो क्या है, vitelline membrane है. तो zona pellucida में एक hole बनाने के बाद it's going to immediately touch the vitelline membrane. The minute it touches the vitelline membrane, the fertilizing receptors are going to get blocked. Samjha? Kya ho gaya? So now kitne bhi spermatozoa andar aane ki koshish karenge, receptors blocked hai, fertilizing anti fertilizing reaction won't be progressing only. So if there is no fertilizing anti fertilizing reaction, will it progress ahead? So someone was asking me just now that how does only one sperm enter and why not many? Uska answer mila beta. Did you all get the answer to this? So what happened? As soon as the sperm head touched the vitelline membrane, immediately the zona pellucida receptors were blocked to accept any further spermatozoa. Theek hai? Samajh mein aa gaya? And rather what will happen, you know? This spermatozoa will become like a thick shield. एक thick shield के जैसा वो behave करेगा. उसका thickness जो है ना, वो बहुत, मतलब पहले वो उसके अंदर जो cytoplasm था या जो liquid था ना, वो अभी jelly के जैसा thick बन गया है. So by chance अगर कोई अंदर आता भी है, by chance जो second है, जो तुरंत अंदर आ गया है ना, वो vitelline membrane तक जाने के पहले zona pellucida got converted into a gel-like, thick, solid-like substance. So through that gel, अभी ये spermatozoa को आगे जाना impossible हो जाएगा. Even if two enters ना, the one who will touch the vitelline membrane first will immediately cause the gelification or solidification of the zona pellucida का fluid to make it, you know, like so sturdy that now to cross that and come inside is impossible. It happens within, you know, few fraction of seconds. It's so fast. Okay, got it. Now a distinct pre-vitelline space is created around the fertilization membrane. सो नाउ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन बेटा, ये है ना ये वाला, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन और इट्स गोइंग टू बी योर सेल मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, एग का सेल मेम्ब्रेन है, इट्स आल्सो कॉल्ड एज फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन. तो अब ये फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन एंड ये वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन, इनके बीच में एक गैप आ जाती है, एक गैप क्रिएट होती है. न्यूक्लियस एंड द सेंट्रियोल टच द वाइटलाइन मेम्ब्रेन अलोंग विद सम अमाउंट ऑफ द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द हेड रीजन, बिकॉज एक्रोसोम तो एक्चुअली फट गया है ना, तो अगर कुछ थोड़ा बहुत बचा है ना तो वो भी टच करेगा. ओके, या व्हाट विल हैपन टू द अदर स्पर्म्स? नथिंग, दे विल बी डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय अवर यू नो प्रोसेस ऑफ फैगोसाइटोसिस एंड ऑल, मैक्रोफेजेस एंड ऑल विल कम एंड अटैक देम एंड दे विल किल देम. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड, सी, कैन यू सी अ स्पेस ओवर हियर कॉल्ड एज प्री वाइटलाइन स्पेस? इट वॉज नॉट देयर फ्रॉम बिफोर, बट नाउ इट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड. Now it has been created. So see, a distinct pre-vitelline space is created around the fertilization membrane. This prevents any further entry of other sperms into the egg. That is, polyspermy is avoided. So now what is happening? Because of this space, what has happened? Agar koi zona pellucida ko cross karke aa gaya, zona pellucida thick ho gaya, uske pehle wo escape karke idhar aa chuka hai, to bhi kya ho jayega? ये स्पेस को ट्रैवल करके टू रीच द फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन तक कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन हो जाएगी. देयर इज गोइंग टू बी द कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन दैट विल बी टेकिंग प्लेस. लुक एट द कॉर्टिकल रिएक्शन बेटा, दीज आर द कैल्शियम आयंस. डू यू रिमेम्बर द कैल्शियम आयंस वर प्रेजेंट इन द स्पर्मेटोजोआ, है ना? नाउ दे आर गोइंग टू बी डिपॉजिटेड ओवर हियर व्हिच इज Ca+2. मतलब यहाँ पर कौन सा चार्ज आ जाएगा? दीज आर द कैल्शियम आयंस. Which charge will be imparted onto the inner side of the fertilization membrane? Will it be a positive charge or will it be a negative charge? Can you tell me? Calcium andar aaya matlab with charge? Yes. Judy, you are right, beta. Why a question mark? Ca+2 andar aaya hai. Plus two. So which particular charge it's going to have? Why only one answer? Come on, others try to answer this question. Yes, Sara. Very correct. Yes, Medan, right, beta? Okay, it's +2. So obviously, it's going to impart a positive charge. Okay, now this positive charge over here in this particular region, okay, inside the oocyte membrane, will cause the calcium ions to go and touch this pre-vitelline space. Enter into this pre-vitelline space and act like soldiers not to allow anyone else to come inside. So, ये जो calcium ions अंदर आए हैं ना, ये spermatozoa में से जो calcium ions अंदर आए हैं, ये सारे calcium ions अभी थोड़े से change हो जाते हैं, charge positive रहता है, क्या होगा वो आगे बताऊंगी. And they will act like soldiers. They will go and they will guard this entire lining of the oocyte. Okay. And suppose दूसरा कोई sperm अंदर आता भी है ना, तो ये जो calcium ions के ये जो cortical granules बने हैं ना, अब they won't allow anyone else to enter inside. So you understood how the reactions are taking place to avoid polyspermy. बिल्कुल समझ में आ गया. So see what has happened. See, the sperm nucleus and the centrioles enter the egg. ये पहले हमने general देखा था, अब देखो उन्होंने बताया है. As soon as the sperm head touches the vitelline membrane, a cortical reaction gets activated, changing the vitelline membrane into fertilization membrane by deactivating the sperm receptors of zona pellucida. A distinct pre-vitelline space is created around the fertilization membrane. This prevents any further entry on the other sperms into the egg. That is, polyspermy is avoided. Okay? Enters and all this happens, and then the sperm cells die off midway. The best one is generally the one who would reach, na beta. So it is the most competent one. Depolarization. That is what I'm talking about. See? So now the there was a negative charge over here initially. Now, because of the entry of the calcium ions, the negative charge is reversed, and a positive charge is going to be, imparted on this particular fertilization membrane, right? So this particular, change of the polarity from negative to positive, or rather uptaking of the calcium ions more and more inside, is called as depolarization wave. Okay, so this is called as cortical reaction and depolarization. ठीक है, okay, fine, हाँ, okay. Now listen to this one more time, बेटा. Listen to this one more time. This is very important and this is very crucial. I'll just explain it one more time to all of you all. Yes, it happens the same with our nerves. Yes, Ru. Yes, with Na plus and K plus. Agree. Yeah. So this is going to be, like in general, till first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth point. Huh? They're talking in general. But टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग ना प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ बोथ द सेल्स डिसॉल्व, इसके पहले ये वाला पॉइंट है ना, ये आप रीड करो तो आपको और सही समझेगा. तो क्या होता है देखो, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस. दिस कॉजेस एग रिएक्शन, दैट इज अ स्मॉल फर्टिलाइजेशन कोन और कोन ऑफ रिसेप्शन इज फॉर्म्ड ऑन द एग मेम्ब्रेन. एग मेम्ब्रेन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज योर फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन. ठीक है, द स्पर्म हेड कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद दिस कोन. But before it comes in contact with this cone, what happens over here? See, as soon as the sperm head touches the vitelline membrane, so before touching the membrane of the egg, it has to touch the vitelline membrane. A cortical reaction gets activated, changing the vitelline membrane into fertilizing membrane by deactivating the sperm receptors of zona pellucida. So what has happened? As soon as the head of the sperm touches the zona pellucida, acrosome will rupture. It will cause